Snastruck.
Thanks to Sean Bird for the request on my Patreon page. It's King Arthur and the Knights of Justice, not to be confused with King Arthur's World, which is a completely different game entirely. This game is made distinct by two things. One is that it's published by Enix, more on that a little later, and it's also based on an early 90s cartoon of the same title that I myself have never heard of. The premise of the show is King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table getting trapped somewhere, so the wizard Merlin travels through time to find a replacement King Arthur and replacement knights, settling on a modern-day high school quarterback coincidentally named Arthur King, and his teammates are named the new Knights of the Round Table, and they're supposed to rescue the real knights. Is that ridiculous enough for you? Here's the thing about this game, though. It has the pieces in place to be at least halfway decent. Take one glance at the gameplay, and it certainly looks okay as a top-down hack-and-slash-adventure-style game. Surely it's gotta be at least as good as something like Young Merlin or Lagoon, right? Especially if Enix put their name on it. But sadly, King Arthur and the Knights of Justice is a complete freaking mess. You play as Arthur, and you get to pick two AI-controlled knights to accompany you. There's 11 knights to choose from, each with their own unique stats, ranging in strength, speed, defense, and hit points. And hey, check this out, it's top-down fighting with weapons and stuff, just like games like Secret of Mana. Look, it even has a similar meter that recharges after every swing of your sword. Only it recharges at a much, much slower pace. And, the hit detection here could use a little more fine-tuning, to say the least. In fact, why bother doing anything at all when my two henchmen can evidently go anywhere they want and take care of every enemy without my help. Jeez. Okay, so we're out here, we're fighting guys, and where the hell do I go? Oh, okay, there must be something beyond these statues. Oh, I guess I can't go that way. Maybe I walk through this fire? Nope, but at least I get a message giving me some information for once. Let's try the other side of the map. And it's a dead end. So you wander, and you wander, and you wander, and wander. And hey, there's a cave! Wow, an actual person to talk to! But he won't let me continue unless I find his lost book. Dude, I've been all over this stupid map, and I haven't seen one freaking book. That is your problem. What I ended up doing is going through the Wall of Fire. You gotta collect four things hidden on the map, as well as a hidden magic shield, and haul them back to Merlin so he can make some potion or something. It's all very tedious. Yeah, this is one of those games, similarly structured to Young Merlin, which I just looked at a few months ago. Everything here is laid out as a big fetch quest. You wander around aimlessly finding stuff to give to other people who give you something else to give to someone else, which unlocks another area where you do the same thing all over again. In the case of Young Merlin, that approach may be annoying, but it still passes as a decent enough game. I mean, it's still playable. In King Arthur and the Knights of Justice, this structure is incredibly tedious and annoying because, well, where the hell am I going? Oh, you mean there's an area tucked in here? Are you kidding? And this is at the very beginning of the game, too. The biggest problem isn't just the fetch quest structure, it's that everything here looks the same, areas are all indistinguishable from each other, and the map does not help at all. Okay, I can see where I am, but where am I in reference to what I can actually see in the game? So anyway, you eventually find this house buried in the woods, and this dude needs his helmet. You find the helmet in that hidden area in the woods I showed you earlier. Helmet guy then gives you a book, you give the book to a guy in the cave, and so on and so forth, all while fighting anonymous soldiers and monsters and stuff. The goal here is to find the 12 keys of truth, each of which are being held by a warlord that you have to defeat after traversing through a dungeon. Now, what's confusing about all that is that the game tells you that each of the 11 knights, including King Arthur, or sorry, Arthur King, they can each get a key, so it implies that you need to pick the correct knight to take with you before each dungeon. And how do you know which knights? The game does not tell you. If I had a hold of the instruction book, I might be able to give you some more info there, but I was not able to find a copy of one. And I guess I shouldn't be surprised by that. I can't see a reason why anyone would still keep a manual for this game, let alone scan it and put it online. King Arthur and the Knights of Justice has been ignored and forgotten for good reason. It's a complete mess. You can find tiny positives here and there, like the music is okay, the AI-controlled knights aren't all that terrible, this dragon looks pretty dang sweet, and the nuts and bolts of a decent game are all here. It's just structured in a very, very annoying layout. I'll be honest, I hardly even got that far into this game. It's just such a pain to get to the end of the dungeon, fight the boss and find out you've got the wrong knights to fight it with, so you've got to go back and find someone else. Yeah, you can find so much better than this game. Young Merlin is better, Lagoon is better, organizing your sock drawer is better. Stay far away from this one.